This is the flexible snake with a vise grip mount for holding your dial indicator. The vise grip mount has three locations for the flexible snake to attach to. This is attached by using the threaded part. Vise grip pliers are loosened by pushing this lever right here. Then the adjustment at the far end is the threaded screw. If I loosen the threaded screw, as I close the vise grips, the gap gets larger. This is used for adjusting when we want to clamp onto an object. To make the vise grip tighter, turn the threaded screw clockwise. That will close the gap. However, it doesn't have a whole lot of grip to it right now. I turn the threaded screw just a little bit more. And now when I go to close it, I get resistance further out on the clamping mechanism. Now when I squeeze, it has a much more solid click to it, and it has more clamping force here. That'll hold the vise grip solid on the object that you are clamping to. It also makes it more difficult to release the vise grips. If you make the threaded screw a little bit too tight, you won't be able to clamp all the way down, or it'll be really difficult. Now this one I might be able to get it clamped down, and it's going to be really hard to get loose. The flexible snake gives you a lot of options for adjusting how you want to set your dial indicator up. The flexible snake has the ability to lock into place by using this lever down here. This is a cam locking mechanism, and it pulls on a cable inside the flexible snake. There's an adjuster right here, and this is how you adjust it. If I thread this closer to the head of the mount, you'll see a lot of flexibility or looseness becomes in the cable, and we'll be unable to lock this into position. If, on the other hand, I back this out or thread it backwards to make the flexible snake a little bit stiffer, and this is doing nothing more than tightening the cable inside the mechanism here. Now, if I change the position of this and I move the lever here, it'll get stiff right about here, and if I push a little bit more with some more force, it'll now hold the flexible snake in the position that I put it in. And then you loosen it just by moving the lever back. If you make it too tight, it might be really difficult to bend the snake in the position that you want it in, and you might have a hard time moving your lever. On the end of the snake, where the dial indicator fits, this is a V-clamp with a circular end to it. This is designed for clamping onto round objects. As you tighten the thumb screw, it will reduce the diameter of that mount. That is designed for clamping onto a standard dial indicator or a round mount on a dovetail design. Simply slide the dial indicator through the clamping mechanism and tighten the thumb screw. That'll hold the dial indicator into place. If you want to reposition it, you simply loosen the thumb screw and you can twist the dial indicator or move it into a new position. And then you just simply clamp it down again for it to stay. And finally, on the vise grip end, you can thread this into one of three positions. You can thread it in at the top or one of the side positions right here. The key to doing this is to make sure that it is tight. You don't want it to be loose. If it's loose, you will have a problem with reading accurately. So when we tighten this up, one little tip here is to use the lever as leverage to tighten it up. You don't need to put a wrench on it, but just use this as a lever as you twist the two objects together to try to make them tight. Now they won't come loose very easily, but they won't be on so tight that you're going to need a wrench to take them apart. Just use the lever once again as leverage to loosen the two objects together to separate it. Also, watch these roll pins. Some less expensive designed Vise Grip dial indicator mounts, these roll pins will come loose, it will wiggle back and forth, and that will affect your reading.